Hi, welcome to e-classes. In the last session, we have discussed about what is a cloud computing and what are all the different deployment modes and what are the different kind of services under cloud computing. So today we are going to discuss about what are all the benefits of cloud computing. Why the clients or the customers are moving from on-premises to cloud computing. So before we are going to discuss about these benefits, I just want to recall what we have discussed in the last session. So what is a cloud computing? And what are the different deployment modes? So deployment modes means you can set up your cloud computing a private in your organization or in one of the trusted cloud services in a data center, and a public is a common for everyone, and it is shareable to all the people, and a hybrid. So hybrid is the combination of private and public. Some confidential applications, if you want to run under the private cloud, you can, and some unconfidential, unsecurable applications you can run under the public cloud. So basically, where these cloud data centers are placed, so that we are calling it's a deployment of the cloud. Let's say, for example, we have Azure, Microsoft Azure. So Microsoft Azure is a public cloud. It's a public cloud. So some of the customers, some of the clients, because of their data security issues, they may not go to this public cloud. So that is the reason what they will do. They may set up this cloud computing in their own data center. So then it is more securable and it is under control of them. So they can control this data center and all services. So these are the different deployment modes. Coming to the hybrid, few of the applications, whatever are confidential, they can run under private, and whatever are not much important, they will go with the public. So that is a hybrid deployment mode. So coming to this cloud computing, so cloud computing is through the internet, the services can be provided by the some of the service providers like Microsoft Azure or AWS. If you want to set up something in your organization, if you want to build an application, the required software is required, networking, operating system, virtual machines, all those things you don't need to install on your computer. Through the web, you can directly connect to the service provider. And whatever the services, whatever the applications, whatever the softwares you are looking, you can use those things and you can install in the cloud computing only. You can design your application. So that is the cloud computing. And coming to this, what are the different kind of services we have under this cloud computing is, yes, infrastructure as a service and PaaS, platform as a service, and SaaS, software as a service. So what is the difference between this EaaS, PaaS, SaaS? EaaS is going to focus more on the infrastructure kind of thing, like hard disk, CPU. So what you can do, instead of maintaining the hard disk space, memory in your data centers, in your computer, you don't need to purchase this hard disk. Directly you can use this hard disk space in the cloud. So how much memory you want, how much memory you are utilizing, just go and pay how much you are using. That is nothing but pay as you go. Okay, so in this EaaS, they are covering CPUs and hard disk. Coming to the platform as a service, they are going to provide some more thing like networking and some of the softwares. Let's say, for example, if you want a SQL server, you can install the SQL server inside and you can utilize that SQL server. How many core processors are required, how much data you want to store, you just pay for that. So currently the Microsoft Azure is running under the platform as a service. So they don't have service as a software as a service. So coming to the software as a service, it's an application, already designed application you can utilize, like Office 365 or Gmail or Yahoo Mail. So those are the applications already designed and you are not going to do anything. You are just using that service, that is software as a service. Under the platform as a service, whatever the softwares you are required, anything Oracle, SQL or BI or .NET, any kind of thing, you can just pay and use that service. So yes, it's just providing the some infrastructure. Now, what are the benefits of this cloud computing? Why most of the clients are moving to this cloud computing? The first primary thing is low cost. So what will happen if you just want to set up an database server like SQL server just for testing an application, and this testing will be done just for 1 week with minimal data, even though you need to purchase the SQL server license on premises, at least you need to spend $3,000, right? And after 1 week, you are not going to use this license. But you need to spend initial capital for set up all the softwares, hard disk, CPU, networking, operating system, and SQL server database. All you need to purchase, all the licenses you need to purchase. So the capital cost, the investment is more when you are installing all this in on-premises. So instead of purchasing all this in on-premises, simply you can go to cloud. What are all the services you required and how long you required and how much you want to utilize, you just pay for that one. It will start minimum from $5. Let's say, for example, I just want a SQL Server OLTP database with 100 MB space. You can pay $5. So this is the way you can reduce your capital cost and also the maintenance of the softwares. You don't need to put any effort or you don't need to spend any maintenance cost for the software. And the second advantage is productivity. So productivity in the sense, usually in your organization, when you have all this infrastructure in on-premises, you need to focus on two things. One is administration. Another one is development. So now if you are using the cloud computing, then you don't need to worry about this administration part. Everything the cloud provider will take care. Only you have to concentrate on the development. So if you are concentrating on the development, you will get more productivity. So this is the way you will get more productivity. And the third thing is security. In on-premises, if you want to secure your data, you have to follow many things. In the cloud computing, they are making your data very securable with two-factor authentication. And also in Microsoft Azure, you have Active Directory. So it is more securable compared to any other service providers. And the next one is data replication. So data replication is whatever the data, whatever the applications you are running, it will replicate in three geographical locations. If anything happened in one of the locations, it is available in another two locations. You just imagine, if you are using on-premises, how much cost it will take to maintain these three replication of the data for your on-premises database. So, but here in this cloud computing, they are keeping your data more places, more than one geographical location. If any place is downtime or something is happened, then other two places you can get your data recovery. So that is the way you don't lose any data. And the next one is upgrade of the software. So for example, you have purchased some SQL Server license and installed on your on-premises. And after, let's say for example, this is 2012 SQL Server. Later you got 2014, and 2016 and 2017. So every time you need to upgrade your softwares, if it is on premises, just imagine how much time, how much resource required, and you need to pay a separate cost every time when you are upgrading your softwares. So definitely it is difficult to upgrade every time your softwares. But in the cloud computing, you don't need to worry about that. The upgrade of the software, the cloud provider will take care automatically. So this is the one of the best benefit from cloud computing. And the next one is flexibility. The flexibility in the sense, let's say, for example, I have purchased 100 GB hard disk. If you want to increase your CPU or a hard disk, or if you want to upgrade, then definitely it is a headache process in on-premises systems. If you want to increase your memory or CPU or RAM space, something, if you want to increase something, definitely it is a headache process in the on-premises. But when you are coming to cloud computing, it's seconds of the time. Within the seconds, with one click, you can increase your capacity of your softwares or the memory, hard disk or CPU, whatever. So that is the flexibility you have. You can compute your cloud services within the minutes and seconds. And the next one is collaboration. So you can connect from anywhere and all the people can connect to the service provider and they can work on their applications. And the next one is mobility. So the mobility in the sense, you can connect to this cloud through any device, because nowadays the people are using mobile phones and tablets or PCs, computers. So you can connect to this service cloud provider and you can work on your tasks from anywhere and from any machine. So no need to support your device operating system or whatever. If you have the Google Chrome or Microsoft Edge or Internet Explorer, then you can log into this service provider account and you can utilize this one. So these are all the benefits of the cloud computing. So that is the reason most of the clients, to reduce their cost, their software cost, and to reduce their maintenance cost, and because of the security and because of this data replication and easily to upgrade the softwares and easily to compute their softwares, they are moving to this cloud computing. So in the next video, I'm going to explain what is a Microsoft Azure and how are we going to create a Microsoft account and what are all the services we are going to use under the Microsoft Azure account. Thanks for watching this video.